Subscribers and viewers of our big channel, I welcome you back to this wonderful channel. Yeah, it's been a while since you guys heard from me. Actually, I had the chance to relocate to the United States of America, and so that's where I'm doing this video from. In this video, I'm going to talk about mangle rules in Mikrotik. Right, so someone will ask, what is a mangle? You will actually find a mangle rule in the firewall tab in Mikrotik. The mangle is a kind of marker that marks packets for future processing with special marks. Many other facilities in router OS make use of these marks, example Q3's NAT routing. They identify a packet based on its mark and process it accordingly. The mangle marks exist only within the router. They are not transmitted across the network. Additionally, the mangle facility is used to modify some fields in the IP header, like TOS and TTL fields. Firewall mangle rules consist of 5 predefined chains that cannot be deleted. Right, so these chains consist of the pre-routing chain. In this case, rules in this chain apply to packets as they just arrive on the network interface. The second one to talk about is the input chain. In this case, rules in this chain apply to packets just before they are given to a local process. The third one is the output chain. In this chain, the rules here apply to packets just after they have been produced by a process. And then the fourth one is the forward chain. The rules here apply to any packets that are routed through the current host. Then the last one to talk about is the post routing chain. In this chain, the rules in this chain apply to packets as they just leave the network interface. So kindly stay tuned and then we can go through several configurations with regards to Mangle in Mikrotik. Thank you. Let's quickly log in into my router, and in this case I'm going to set a mangle rule for my IP address, my laptop's IP address, okay? And it's going to be a set of 2 mangle rules. So let me quickly log in here. As you can see from this mangle tab in the firewall rule, I actually did a mangle rule for my network, and this is it, which is a rule I did for a VPN client I'm using. Okay, so currently this is it. And this is the routing mark it passes through. Okay, so this is what I have. This is something which is in my system already and I did the configuration of that. So let me handle the new one I'm talking about, which is with regards to my current IP. So quickly click on plus to add a mangle rule, and in this case the chain I'm using is the forward chain. Okay, then I specify my source IP address, which is my laptop's IP address. Okay, so this is it, and that is the source address. The in interface is my local area network, is the same as my bridge. Okay, then the connection state is new. So this is what you do on this part of the new mangle rule. The next one is for you to move to the action side of it, and then you click on mark connection, right? So here you need to specify the new connection mark, which is not here, so I just need to type in the new connection mark, which is okay. Let me just do this. and done. Then you click OK. The next thing is to configure a MAC connect. So do the same thing, come to this side and select the forward chain and then click on connection MAC. This is my connection MAC which I configured earlier. And then straightforward, move to action and select MAC packet. This is MAC packet, which also has nothing. So all I need to do is to client dash P or underscore P, right? This is just a term, you can change it. I can decide to make it net P or something, anything else. When you're done, you click on apply and okay. So you can see traffic going on currently. Example on this one, the Mangle rule I've just set here applies to this particular IP. Okay, so this clearly indicates that I've just set a firewall Mangle rule for my IP which has a connection established already. So any traffic that passes through this Mangle has been established, and the router wouldn't have to be worried about a new connection coming from my IP. You see? So this is a typical example of a Mangle rule in Mikrotik Firewall using the forward chain. Right, we have certain default ones which are here. Example, we have this, these are by default on the system. Okay, this actually uses the pre-routing Mangle rule. And if you see the action, it is passed through. So these are certain default ones which per the configuration I did, it automatically generated a Mangle rule for me. So this is how it works like. So you have this, which is a forward chain. Okay, this is the pre-routing chain, and then you have the post-routing chain. Okay, all allows passing through, but this one is a Mangle rule I configured based on my L2TP client that I use. So currently I use this VPN in my Mikrotik router, which kind of shield me from traceability, and then allows me to be able to change my location to any part of the world I want. And so this is the configuration I did for that, which is working perfectly. Okay, and this is the example I just configured to show you example on how Mangle rule works. Alright, thanks for watching this video. If there are any questions bothering your mind, you can ask me in the comments below. And please don't forget to subscribe to my channel, like my videos and share my videos as well. And expect the next video very soon. Thank you.